Now that all the mundane classes are out of the way, we can move on to something that's more magical. We're going to talk about spell changes and small changes to feats. This is playtest 6, by the way. Anyways, welcome to Pack Tactics, where spells are features, and the most important features of all. Let's start with a new cantrip, Elementalism. It's on the Arcane and Primal spell lists. Elements Monk gets access to this too. This is similar to Thaumaturgy, so it's nothing special. It's mostly just fluff. I don't see a reason for this addition. I guess they wanted to give Elements Monk something, but still though, it's pretty weird. They should have just given the Elements Monk a spell list instead. Now let's get into the real spells. Hunter's Mark, once again, ranger-only spell, which is fine. The only thing that's not fine is it only works once per turn, decreasing its effectiveness by quite a lot. It's never worth using your bonus action on casting the spell on a well-built ranger. Now in 1D&D, your bonus action might be opened up to do so, but they nerfed its power, making it a hard sell. And don't get me started on the fact that rangers don't even get to cast this without concentration anymore. I'll talk about this in the Ranger video itself, spoilers. If you upcast the spell to 3rd or 4th, you can concentrate on the spell for longer and you get a damage bump. At 5th level, this happens again. The thing is, I would rather cast and concentrate on different things when using those spell slots. This is super weak. If anything, they should be moving it to a place where Hunter's Mark is stronger than the 5e version, not the opposite. I'll link my Hunter's Mark video down in the description for more details. That video is super old. I like that video. The other two spells that are now Ranger exclusive and receive changes are Conjure Barrage, which now also works with melee weapons and does 5d8 damage instead of 3d8. Both of these are good changes. Now it's quite similar to a no friendly fire fireball with a bigger affected area, a better damage type, but a little bit less damage. Flat out, I would never cast this in 5e, but now it's some decent Nova, so now it's more appealing. Conjure Volley also works with melee weapons too now, but was not changed beyond that. So it's still not something I would pick up for my Ranger builds. That's kind of disappointing. Next, Hex. Tiny change, it's now a Warlock-only spell. This is completely fine. Vicious Mockery, this is now a Bard exclusive. It's got some good changes. It now works on creatures that can hear or see you, instead of only being sight-based. And the spell now deals damage in D6s instead of D4s. One additional thing is that damage only increases on Bard level ups, nothing else. The spell has become a bit more competitive to others, but its rider effect still outgrows its worth quite quickly as enemies start getting multi-attack more and more. Next, I'm gonna cast a no-safe spell where you have to watch this ad. It's about the Ethereal Expanse setting guide. Sail your ship across a sea of starlight and plunder ships for loot. It's optimal to collect all the shinies and hoard it all up like a dragon. This guide is by the guys who made Grim Hollow. I really like Grim Hollow. Anyways, tons of lore and adventure ideas for your campaign in this alien world. Tons of new player options, including 12 new subclasses, new magic items, and many brand new mechanics like the Heritage Trait System, which allows you to build your character species with over 50 different traits to pick from. And best of all, ship rules! You can build your own crew, upgrade your ships, and have ship combat! And lastly, there's a bunch of new monsters, over 30 of them to slay! The Ethereal Expanse is now live on Kickstarter, an epic adventure you'll remember for years. I highly recommend you check them out, it's gonna be amazing. Back to the video, let's talk about smites. I'll be referring back to this paladin video, so pay attention. First off, smite spells no longer work with ranged weapons compared to the last playtest. Second, divine smite is now a spell. Third, all smite spells except for searing smite and wrathful smite are paladin only. Now, let's look at divine smite itself. This feature or spell has become a lot worse now, mainly because you need to spend a bonus action to use it. In 5e, you can do it as part of any attack. Polar Master is a prime pick for paladins as it allows them to get off an additional attack, but this competes with that now. If we assume we have hit as part of our action, we are looking at an additional 9 damage on average by spending a spell slot, or an average of around 7 without if we assume a 65% to hit, plus 4 strength, dueling, and a glaive with Polar Master. This spell slot has become a lot less useful because it adds less compared to the turns where you don't spend spell slots. Polar Master is still useful because the 7 DPR without expending a spell slot is good. By the way, all smites are bonus action. You can't even use Divine Smite and other smite spells in the same turn. That really sucks. They really should remove the bonus action cost somehow, at least for Divine Smite. Right now, it's barely worth using the default smite, because the other options just do more bang for their buck. Let's look at the others. Banishing Smite. Last UA, it didn't require concentration, but the enemy repeatedly got to save against the effect to return. Now, there is one saving throw, but the spell again requires concentration. I think that's a positive trade, however, for some reason, it only does the banishing thing if the target has 50 HP or fewer. That's awful. It sucks. Who would pick this? Imagine using your 5th level spell, the highest you ever get, and the enemy has too much HP. That's gonna feel really bad, and you're never gonna use that spell ever again. Even if they did have fewer than 50 HP, it's still a save. Anyways, I do like the change to Blinding Smite. There's no initial saving throw anymore, but the target does get to try to remove the effect on subsequent turns. There is a problem though, it doesn't say what save it has to make, it just says the blinded target repeats the saving throw. In 5e, it's a constitution saving throw, so I'm guessing it's still that. Searing Smite received a different but similar change. It now deals damage and the creature gets to do a saving throw, instead of the creature being able to save and not take any extra damage at all. It's a con save, by the way. Funnily enough, this upcasts better than Divine Smite, although it's slower. It's a dot. Here's what it says. When you cast a spell using a spell slot of 2nd level or higher, any damage dealt by the spell increases by 1d6 for each slot level above 1st. At level 2, this means you deal a minimum of 4d6 damage, an average of 14. Whereas Divine Smite does 3d8 for an average of 13.5. I don't really mind, because Divine Smite sucks now, so either way. Next, Shining Smite, introduced in the last Paladin playtest as Glimmering Smite, is still super good. Thumbs up. The final change worth mentioning is Wrathful Smite. It was basically killed last time around. Enemies got to do a save instead of needing to do a check. And there was no longer an action needed to try to end the effect. That is still the case, but the spell no longer requires concentration. It's still quite dead. I'm gonna miss this spell. It was a super underrated spell. The final two spells receiving changes are Power Word Heal and Power Word Kill. Power Word Heal is basically never worth picking up over Mass Heal in 5e. Now it shares the same range at 60 feet, making it a bit better, but it's still a tough sell. I do like the changes to Power Word Kill, but it's still not enough. Instead of doing nothing to the targets with more than 100 HP, it now deals 12d12 psychic damage. It's a sizable boost, but a single target meteor swarm is still more effective. And that shouldn't be the case. Besides the spell changes, there were also some spell list changes. Some cantrips from Tashes and Xanathars were added to the various spell lists. I don't really know what's going on there. Maybe they're padding the options a bit. We're just gonna have to wait and see. Frostbite and Thunderclap from Xanathars were added to the Arcane list, as well as the Primal list. Mind Sliver from Tashes was added to the Arcane list. Toll the Dead from Xanathars were added to the Arcane list, as well as the Divine list. Finally, Word of Radiance from Xanathars was added to the Divine list. Some spell schools changed to be more suitable, and Find Steed is now a Paladin exclusive. I think all of this is fair. That's basically all the spells. I'll quickly finish this video by mentioning the changes to feats. The ASI feat can now go to 22 if you take it at level 19. This is okay. Fighting style feats can now only be picked if you already have the fighting style feature. This makes it a bit harder for casters to get them, which is not a big deal because they're not very good, but whatever. But also, marshals don't get fighting styles inherently. I think this might be a bit unnecessary, but
Whatever.
And finally, protection fighting style now imposes disadvantage again, instead of being a minus 2 to hit. That's more aligned to the other features in the game. I think this is fine too. And well, that's basically it. I still have no idea what direction they want to go in regards to spells. We're just gonna have to wait and see. End of video. If you liked this video, please like, share, and subscribe. And if you want to support me on Patreon, you can. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye!